are located just 2 blocks from my mother. Northern Boulevard in France. Happen to get the world's record's fastest talking female. Only the contribution we made on a pre-tax basis. We need you'll save money.
You have set the Guinness Book of World Records. 583 in a minute.
Hi, I'm Fred Capo, the world's fastest talking female and the only author to do a book signing at the top of the world, Kilimanjaro, and down by the wreckside of the Titanic. And this is Fran's World, and welcome to it. The show where you see bizarre, unusual, where I do things that challenge myself. We're looking for people. We're looking for extraordinary people. Why be normal if you could be extraordinary? So where am I today? I am in front of Ripley's, believe it or not, auditorium. Not museum, auditorium. And you know what? It is going to come back to New York in just 2 days. June 21st is going to be the grand opening of the Ripley's Believe It or Not Auditorium. Robert Ripley, who of course is the one that started Ripley's Believe It or Not, back in 1918, had a museum here. He actually coined the term auditorium. And inside, we are going to see some of the most bizarre things from all around the world, things that you can't see anywhere else. There's 24 shrunken heads in there. There's a meteorite that's the third largest in the world. You're going to see a lock of Elvis Presley's hair. There are fantastic things that you're going to see in here that you can't see anywhere else. But you're going to see it here. Where? On Rock Me TV. Don't shrink that screen. Well, I don't know if you could see me, but I am with Jim O'Shea. I know I'm a little short. I'm part of the Ripley's exhibit. I'm one of the midgets. And Jim is the general manager of the Ripley's Believe It or Not Auditorium here in New York. For now, we're going to get a sneak preview of what the museum looks like. Come on. All right, so show us some of the stuff that we have here. Whoa, this guy's hand.
What they say.
Did you hear that? He said, do you know what they say? And you know, we're not going to ask for a we're not going to ask for a demonstration. You are one big fellow, Wadlow. The family album. You notice nobody else is in it because their heads are down here in the shot. Wow, a six-legged cow. And that is not a hairball from the cow, is it?
It is.
Hey! I think I spoke to this girl.
You
look like your voice. Okay. and this is Karen, right?
I am Karen. Karen Eckhouse. I'm assistant manager at Ripley's Times Square.
And I would imagine, just like Jim, you know a lot about the displays here?
I should hope so.
I should hope so, too, right? Exactly. That's why you got the job. So why don't you explain why this guy has no color?
This is a rare albino giraffe. He's one of the few ones ever found. They're so rare in the wild. He was called the Phantom of the Savannah, and he was found on a game preserve, died of natural causes.
I don't think Ripley's would kill him just to bring him to the museum. That would be horrible. Hold on a second first. You're not like a real person or something and going to jump out at me. Okay, so let me just ask you. Holy mo- Okay. All right, I'm moving along. You know, obviously there's a lot of surprises here. So what is this room that we're entering here?
This is actually a room that we call our Stocks and Bonds.
Uh-huh.
It's New York.
Okay, look around. See why he calls it the Stocks and Bonds here. Okay. It's a very New York room, I see. Okay, well, let me just see something here. You know, this reminds me of, what was that, Cannibal Lecter?
Oh, yeah.
You know? It's like one of those, please let me go. I'm very hungry. I need to eat. This looks horrible. What? This is horrible here.
Yeah, this was something called the Iron Maiden. It was, this is from 1593, and it actually was it was pretty much a torture device, but basically when you went inside of it, you never came out of it again. They opened it, and usually they had them on bridges, and so when they opened it, you literally fell into the water and you were dead.
And this is an actual one. This is not a replica.
One. Yeah, this is an actual one from Austria. This was used back at those days, and there's not many of them in the world.
You know, one of the cool things is that seeing something in person is a lot different than seeing it on TV, so you actually have to come down and see this. But this room actually holds 24 shrunken heads. You don't want to be one of the shrunken heads, but I do have to tell you. One of the things about the shrunken heads, I actually traveled with them when I was doing the Ripley's tour, and we were promoting one of the books. And what they do is they sew the mouth shut because they don't want the spirit to escape through the mouth. And that's what they do. And with the women especially, they sew the mouth shut. That's what I found out. With the women! My mouth would have been sewn shut a long time ago. What can I tell you? And right here we have Robert Ripley, the man responsible. Well, not for this museum, because obviously he's not here now, but the man responsible for the idea behind the auditorium, the one that collected all the facts from all around the world. This is the man, because of you, we get to see all of this. Wonderful work, wonderful work. We love you. Well, Karen, I want to thank you very much. That was wonderful. Thank you very much. I'm so glad to be a part of this Ripley's Extravaganza Auditorium. So why don't you, for the people at home who want to be able to come down to New York and visit this museum, first of all, tell us the hours the museum is open.
The museum will be open 365 days from 9 a.m. to 1 a.m.
You hear that? At 1 o'clock in the morning, you're not doing anything. You can come down here, at least 5 to 1. And where are we located exactly again?
We're right on 42nd Street at 234 between 7th and 8th Avenue.
And if you want to find out more information, all you have to do is go to the website, www.ripleysnewyork, that's spelled out, N-E-W-Y-O-R-K, ripleysnewyork.com. Come down and see us right here. Right now, you saw just a little glimpse of what they're going to have here with the big opening, June 21st, on Rock Me TV. Don't shrink that screen. That was fantastic. I love this stuff. It's like so bizarre and unusual, and I mean, it's things you can't see anywhere else. I just love this stuff, and I love that I'm part of it. I'm a Ripley's, believe it or not. I am a Bion. Frank Capo, a Bion. But you know what? If you want to see more of this stuff, come down to Ripley's Believe It or Not Museum on 42nd and Times Square. And you know where you can say it all? You saw it on Rock Me TV. Don't shrink that screen.